You've probably heard by now that Mother Teresa is said to be canonized and become a saint this weekend. But how much do you know about what that actually means? And who decides whether someone is qualified for the honor? It all begins with an investigation into the life and virtues of the person. The case is then put to vote, and the final approval lies in the hands of the Pope. If he votes in favor of the heroic virtues of the person, he or she is elevated to the status of venerable. Though this process is usually not allowed to start within 5 years of the person's death, in the case of Mother Teresa, the rule was waived off by Pope John Paul II. Now, to become a saint, one must be believed to have performed two miracles. The first of Mother Teresa's took place in 1998, when a woman from West Bengal said she was cured of a tumour on the eve of Mother's first death anniversary. When this event was accepted as a miracle, it meant Mother Teresa was now ready for a process known as beatification. Though one step closer to sainthood, a second miracle was required. This was achieved when the Vatican accepted a second proposal that a Brazilian man awoke from a coma after his wife prayed to Mother Teresa. With that, the groundwork was set for Mother's impending canonization. That wasn't too complicated, right?